Welcome to ECSE 597, Circuit Simulation and Modeling. The first topic that we will discuss in our course is modified nodal analysis. If you have a circuit and you'd like to analyze the circuit, the first step is to come up with a mathematical model describing its behavior. And in this video, we're going to introduce modified nodal analysis, which is a systematic way of constructing such a model. Let me start by stating the key learning outcomes. So after this video, and in fact, a series of videos discussing this topic, you'll be able to define what modified nodal analysis is, understand the structure of the MNA equations, identify the advantages of using the MNA formulation itself compared, for example, to other methods like, for example, state space formulation. Understand the concept of element stamps, which are used for automating the construction of the MNA equations. You'll be able to design your own computer program for constructing the circuit equations for common elements. And you'll be able to develop stamps for new elements or new models of existing elements that you have not seen before in this course. As we will often do in this course, we're going to start with an example. So let's take a look at this simple circuit. And we're going to do nodal analysis the same way you would in your first year circuits course. Right? So we're going to take the three nodes of the circuits, node 1, node 2, and node 3. And we're going to apply Kirchhoff's current law at every node. So KCL at node 1, we sum all the currents leaving node 1. So the current in resistor G1 is G1V1. The current leaving through resistor G2 is G2V1 minus V2. And that's equal to the currents entering ISIG here through the independent sources. We apply KCL at node V2. So we have the current leaving node V2 through G2. So this is G2 V2 minus V1. It's negative, this current. And the current leaving through the diode is given by the diode equation. And we apply KCL at node 3. And now we have the current in G3, which is G3 V3. The current in the capacitor, which is C1 V3 dot, the derivative with respect to time. And the current in the diode, which is the negative of this current here, it's going the other direction. So the current leaving node V3 is in this way, and we have minus IS e to the V2 minus V3 divided by VT minus 1. So these are our three equations, and we have three unknowns. Let's rewrite these equations and basically reorder the terms so that we can collect all the terms with V1, all the terms with V2, etc. So we can rewrite these equations in this format. And once we do that, so these are the equations that we had before. We have rewritten them so that you have V1, V2, etc. So I'm going to now easily write them in matrix form. So we have a matrix multiplied by V1, V2, V3, and then, so this is my vector of unknowns, if you will. This is its derivative, and we collect the nonlinear equations in a vector over here. So each row here is one of my three equations. So for example, the first row is G1 plus G2 multiplied by V1, that's the first term over here, minus G2 multiplied by V2, which is the second term over here, is equal to ISIG, which is the right-hand side, right? If I look at the last equation, well, that would be the last row. So that's G3, V3. So that's here, G3, V3, plus C1, V3 dot. So we have here C1, V3 dot. And we have here the nonlinear equation. It appears in this vector over here. So this is my nonlinear term, is equal to 0 on the right-hand side. So one of the things, hopefully, that you will get used to as we look at these equations throughout the course is to look at these equations and read KCL in real time, right? So if we look at these equations, I can now generalize them in this format. So we have gx plus cx dot plus f of x is equal to b. My unknown vector v1, v2, v3, which are the nodal voltages, is in x. So we have x and we have its derivative x dot. The matrix G here, right, we call it, so this matrix multiplying x, we call it the G matrix. The matrix, and typically the G matrix contains the contributions of the memoryless elements. We have the C matrix multiplying x dot. This contains the contribution of the memory elements. We have a nonlinear vector containing the contribution of the nonlinear elements. And we have our right-hand side vector, which contains the independent sources. So this equation here, gx plus cx dot plus f of x is equal to b, is my MNA equation, modified nodal analysis equation. And what we will be doing in the first, I guess, portion of this course is developing systematic techniques for constructing these equations, right? So the idea is we're going to start with a netlist which describes the circuit, right? So this netlist contains a list of elements, which nodes they're connected to, and whatever parameters they have. So we want to start with a netlist and then systematically construct the MNA equations, right? And this is the goal of the first few lectures in this course, and then we can build on that, okay? So in summary, what we discussed today is we gave an example of a circuit with its MNA equations, and we have now an idea of the overall format, right? And an example of a netlist, if you had not seen a netlist before, so that's a spice netlist. And the next steps in the upcoming videos, we are going to look at component stamps, how we automate the construction of the MNA equations. We're going to take a look at the structure of the MNA equations and some of the key advantages of this approach.